Hi, I'm Joe Lichtenberg. I'm Director of Product and Industry Marketing here at InterSystems. And today I'm very excited to introduce to you a new initiative for InterSystems Iris that we're calling Application Starter Packs. And specifically, the first starter pack that we're releasing for InterSystems Iris, which is the Smart Factory Starter Pack for manufacturing companies. Joining me for the presentation today, I'm very pleased that we have Marcel Arts, who's the Chief Information Officer at Vlisco, which is a manufacturing company based in the Netherlands. Marcel is extremely experienced in applying data and analytics to create business value for manufacturing companies. And he's been working hard to bring smart factory and digital transformation concepts to Vlisco. Marcel will talk to us today about how Vlisco is using InterSystems Iris with the new Smart Factory Starter Pack to improve the quality and the efficiency of Vlisco's manufacturing operations. And also joining us today is Marco Den Hartog, who is the CTO at our longtime partner, IT Visors. And Marco will talk to us in detail about the starter pack itself. So I'd like to start by describing this new initiative that we call Application Starter Packs. So Application Starter Packs are essentially application frameworks that work with InterSystems Iris that extend the capabilities of Iris to more closely address a specific class of problems in a specific industry. So they're not packaged applications, but they're more like extensible frameworks that extend the core capabilities of Iris. And they're intended to be customized and extended by you, our partners and customers, to meet your specific requirements and used in production. So the starter packs are released as open source code, so you and the user community at large can add more features and capabilities. And then if you choose, submit them back to us for submission to the starter pack so they can grow over time. And the first one we're releasing is the Smart Factory Starter Pack for manufacturing companies. So this starter pack provides manufacturing companies with real-time visibility into their manufacturing processes. It helps them improve the quality and the efficiency of their manufacturing processes. And it helps them turn their factories into smart factories by ingesting real-time signals from their machines on the shop floor through an industry standard protocol that's called OPC UA. It integrates the real-time signals with their manufacturing software and their enterprise software, including manufacturing execution systems and ERP systems and data warehouses and so on. And it provides a real-time operational view of the manufacturing equipment and the processes. And also by calculating real-time key performance indicators like overall equipment effectiveness or OEE, which is a common and critical KPI for manufacturing companies that they often use to manage their business. And then providing all of this information in a comprehensive manner to key personnel through real-time dashboards and real-time alerts and so on. So again, we're very excited to present to you the new Smart Factory Starter Pack. And here to talk about how Vlisco is using InterSystems Iris and the starter pack to help them transform their factory into a smart factory is Marcel Arts, CIO of Vlisco. Marcel?
Well, thank you, Joe, for the introduction, and hello to everybody. As a CIO, I'm looking for opportunities to boost the digital transformation within our factory, which allows us to transform towards a smart factory. I would like to share with you why and how we have positioned the Smart Factory Starter Pack at Vlisco, and why this is the foundation of the Smart Factory. But let me first introduce Vlisco. Vlisco is a Dutch textile company that exists over 170 years. We design, as you can see on the picture, and produce African prints based on the traditional Indonesian batik technique using wax. Vlisco is mainly bought by West African women on the local marketplaces of Nigeria, Togo, Benin, Ivory Coast, and Congo, or one of our 20 shops that we have locally. It's quite unusual for a textile company to produce in Europe. We're able to do so by continuously improving our unique production facility. So let's talk about the why of the smart factory. And let's talk about the starter pack itself. And let's start with what's most important to Vlisco, which is the product quality. First, we are a premium and luxury brand, so consumers have high expectations about the quality of our fabrics. Second, we need to produce right first time as much as we can to justify a production facility in a high-cost country. So it takes about 20 steps on average to produce our fabric. We believe we can reduce scrap at every production step with at least 1%, which results immediately in a financial benefit of 50,000 euros per year. So therefore, we're continuously looking for quality improvements. In addition, we need to produce as efficient as possible to stay in the market. Long-term goal is to work with a digital twin in the factory, where the operator manages production via a control room rather than being on the shop floor itself. Ideally, the production process manages itself by auto-correcting process parameters based on data and advanced business logic. Machine behavior becomes more predictable, and if you combine that, well, then you have a real smart factory. So next step is how to improve product quality using the smart factory starter pack. And we're using very old machines, as you can see on the right. So how can you be future ready? How can you make a starter pack? How can you use all of this new technology within an older factory? So what we're going to do is we're going to analyze 25 million data points per machine per day for a longer period of time and for multiple machines. This means that you look at the full production process from start to end. And then you get new in-depth understanding of our production process, which is not possible at the moment and it's not possible before. Secondly, by warning operators and supervisors when unwanted conditions appear, which may not be detectable by operators, we immediately have impact on our product quality. Thirdly, we're developing real-time dashboards for the operator in which all relevant information is received during every step of the production process. This implies that we need to bring real-time data, which includes complex calculations and is enriched by other applications like work order instructions. Data is the founder of all these quality improvements, and Flisco will become a smart factory by implementing the InterSystems Smart Factory Starter Pack together with IT Visors. Well, let's talk about the implementation of the Smart Factory Starter Pack. If you look on this picture, you see from bottom to top, you see industry automation, which is about managing the OT, the operational technology from the machines, which means the PLCs, sensors, etc., and bring the data via the data acquisition layer into the IT world via a so-called OPC UA server and stores the data into a smart data lake, which is the Iris data platform. Here, the data is directly consumable by shop floor, MES applications, ERP applications, or the data can be used by analytical tools like MATLAB and Qlik platform or Power BI, whatever you use. So looking at the added value of the Smart Factory Starter Pack, first of all, it's scalable, it's robust. It can handle streaming data with real-time in and output, which is quite unique in this field, which is also really necessary to even work within a factory. Second, it's about smart data lake. It's about storing centrally raw data, calculated data, and enriched data. Enriched data, I mean with that you can add information from other applications. So on the top, you see Oracle GD Edwards, which is our ERP system. And we integrate information from there into the smart data lake, which can be combined and used for analytics, for example. And you see that on the right. It's called Advanced Analytics through MATLAB, or it can be via Qlik, our Qlik platform. When it's in the smart data lake, then you can use it for analytics, but you also want to use it for the rest of the shop floor. And you can use it. What you want to do is you want to reuse the machine setup. You want to reuse it from PLC to ERP and ensure a fast rollout, which is very important if you want to roll out the smart factory to the whole plant rather than just local on one of your work centers. And fourth, it all comes together in the operator screen, which at the end of the day will result in a higher product quality by providing all this information real time to the operator. There you can combine advanced analytics and application integration into one place for the operator. If you look at future enhancements, the Iris Data Platform is a foundation of new improvements. You can use the Smart Factory Startup App to connect all relevant machines and applications. As I said, it's a way of reusing components, and then you can roll out really fast to all the other machines on the plant, which is very important because then you can have an end-to-end analysis throughout your production process. You can facilitate custom operator screens with alerts on business logic. And it can embed machine learning models in operator screens to enhance operator alerting. So you can embed advanced analytics into the operator screens. What's also very important to us is a visualization of the machine performance on plant level, which is digital twin. So you can have a look at real-time performance of all the machines at once. So for a supervisor of a certain department, it's important to see all the machines who is responsible for. And we can start improvement projects based on advanced analytics and integral production process. Rather than just on the local improvements, we can see, okay, what's the best combination? What's the optimal performance if you look at the total plant, if you look at the total production process? In addition, we're going to enhance predictive maintenance to improve the production output reliability. And what we would like to do in the future is that we can predict manufacturing quality, meaning right first time percentage of new products even before release. So we want to find out what are the determining variables to estimate upfront what the quality will be in the future. Last, I would like to talk about something which is a very nice combination of visual quality control in combination with machine learning. And what we want to do is we want to put a high-speed camera over the production line, which every second images are shot of every part of the fabric. And all these images are analyzed by a machine learning model, and it checks if the print is correct or not. So when the print is correct, it'll just pass. When the print is not correct, it will provide an alert, for example, or it will stop the machine, or it will adjust the machine, depending on the severity of the found error. So this is what we're going to do with the Smart Factory Startup Pack at Flisco. Now I would like to give the floor to Marco. He can explain it from IT Vice's point of perspective. Marco?
Welcome all. And thank you, Marcel, for your inspirational talk. My name is Marco den Hartog, and I'm the Chief Technology Officer at iDevices. We are arriving in a time in which technology and the real world meet, and together make the connected industry that we know today. Smart factories with connected machines and intelligence embedded in their processes. Factories are changing from individual machines to larger intelligent networks of machines, business systems, and external data that is connected to one another. Together, they make the leap into the intelligent industry possible. This requires adjustments in both technology and in the way of thinking. This is where the expertise of iDevices comes in to consume, process, and analyze the data in high speed with its underlying data platform, InterSystems Iris, with the development of the Smart Factory Starter Pack. So, in my presentation, I will give you an overview what we have built for the starter pack and what the ideas are for further future enhancements. We will be using InterSystems Iris Data Platform as the data platform for Flisco to realize their vision on the Smart Industry 4.0. For this, we have designed a three-layer architecture to store, transform, and serve the data. And I will walk you through this. The staging layer is the layer underneath. It's the foundation of our incoming raw data from machines, sensors, devices, files, business systems, or general available APIs like weather information or water temperature information, but could be even more. This data is collected and stored for a long time in the system. The time that this data is stored can be, of course, be different per factory. On top of the staging layer, we have the transformation layer. The transformation layer, of the transforming layer, is to perform cleanup, normalizations, aggregation of data from different systems, and to perform standard calculations that are needed for different serving needs. With our replay service, you are able to reconstruct a particular day for investigation. Depending on your needs, you can store the data for medium or long-term duration. At last, we have the serving layer. The serving layer is for serving results to the world via cubes, dashboards, reporting tools, analytics, and business applications. Outcomes can be stored for short, medium, or long term, depending on the serving needs. For example, real-time dashboard outputs are stored for a short amount of time, but analytics for a long time. A big advantage of this solution is that the outcomes of the serving layer can be used again in the transforming layer. For example, with the help of automated ML to optimize the process even more. But what have we developed in the starter pack? We have developed a smart metadata configuration for your equipment and data models, all based on REST. On the second, we have a smart dynamic model generation based on the configuration you have made and also available in the REST. We have tested this design of those both, and we have tested this, and we were capable of adding new machines within Flisco within 5 minutes to start, and within 5 minutes to start data coming into the staging layer. So that was really impressive. Smart ingestion of data via OpenCUA, REST, or OWC. Right? We have storing data in dynamic models that can be extended over time, so we're not fixed to the model you've made in upfront. And real-time processing and calculations are performed on the incoming raw data. That's all in the three-layer architecture that is built up to do this. On the other hand, we have OAA integrated data model available and calculations with the needed calculations. This can be used as a template for all the factories that want to use OAA. Functionality to push data direct via the push dataset integration to Power BI in the Azure cloud for a real-time view on your dataset. Oracle GD Edwards integration template for retrieving batch data. So the starter pack real-time OAA. The starter pack, we have built the starter pack around this architecture, where in the one end OpenCUA server of Softing is letting data in, getting the order information from Oracle GD Edwards and showing the OAE to the OAE dashboards in Power BI. This how this dashboard will look like. The OE real-time dashboard looks like this in Power BI, and you can use it on your PC, on your mobile telephone, or your tablet. That's all because we use Power BI. On the other hand, we have made, together with the OEE dashboard, we have made a template within Flisco to inform the operator of the quality of the operations performed. So this is our quality dashboard, also made in Power BI. And then I want to start you with I want to tell you how we are going to extend the Smart Factory Starter Pack in the Flisco environment. First, we are getting all the machines online, normalize the data, and just starting retrieving the data. And directly making the data accessible for other tooling. Next, we will activate alerting for all operators. And we will start adding more information from other enterprise systems. Introduce AutoML features, adding automatic quality of the cloth with the help of cameras, and making the suggestions to the operators of the settings in the machine and how they can optimize it, and much, much more. All these generic components or templates we will make for Flisco will be available in the Smart Factory Starter Pack in the end. When you have more questions, you can reach me by email, marco.denhartog@idevices.com. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Marco, and thank you, Marcel. That was great. And so for more information on the starter pack, and to go and download the starter pack and use it for yourself, simply visit openexchange.innersystems.com, where you'll find the code and the documentation all there for you to access. Thank you very much.